Welcome to the Practical Ascension Podcast. I'm your host and soul alchemist, Tracy Goody. Stay with me for practical guidance and flow for your modern life through this time of ascension. This is what I mean by ascension and playing your part. Now, it's obvious that we are moving through a doorway of human evolution right now. We are shifting and we will come out stronger. Yet when there is transformation, there must be awareness of what is being released. There will be some version of chaos. In order for transformation to truly happen, we must dive in deeper and heal on more levels than we were even previously aware of. The universe is not messing around right now. Our ascension could go kind of more like a gentle waking up, one piece at a time. And that's what we've been doing for the last 10 years. And now in 2020, the volume is turned up to really create this catalyst and ignition that we really need for change. If we want to evolve, we must engage the depths of heaviness, both within ourselves and in our unique way in the physical world. I believe that all of us carry our own responsibility for awareness and healing within, and only when we courageously put our attention on this space can we take the most impactful actions in the outer world. And whenever I use the word courageous, it's really coming from the heart chakra. It's really coming from a place of openness, coming from a place of acceptance, coming from this place of ready to kind of really dive in. So courage is less about putting yourself in danger's way in the way that I'm using it, and more about putting yourself in an open-hearted position, because this is where you can make some really big changes within yourself. So ascension, in my perspective, is really twofold. Ascension is the awareness and release of heaviness. It is first ignited by noticing something is off. Then once you bring awareness to it, it's then your job to ask, what can I do to shift this? This is what brings us to the second aspect of ascension, which is embodiment. So if we truly want to see the change and hold the vision for an empowered future of peace, we must embody that change. Embodiment means that you are it, you live it, you emit it. So when you're doing that, you are telling everybody around you, you're telling the collective, you're telling the world, this is my vote. This energy that I am emitting is what I am voting for the collective. It's what I'm voting for as the predominant energy for everybody and for myself. When you practice proactive ascension, of this awareness, this healing, and this embodiment, you move into your space of highest potential for impact. So that's the embodiment that I'm talking about. And we need your highest potential for impact right now, especially if you're being called up as a light worker, a warrior of the light, a way shower, a leader, or a role model. I do understand that it is not the easy choice to dive into these depths, to be courageous, and to tune into your inner vision for an ascended earth. But we need every single unique perspective. So what I'm encouraging you to do is to tune into your own unique perspective and ask in your heart, what is your why? And if you're in business, you've heard this before. I'm asking you to go bigger and I'm asking you to go deeper than that, right? Not just your why for business or for a project you're working on. Go bigger and go deeper. What is your why? What is it about this vision that wakes you up and lights you on fire? We all have a unique divine light mission and a specialized set of skills and passions to make it happen. We are designed to make it happen. We are designed to help bring our mission into reality. We wouldn't have these desires to bring this into reality if we didn't also have the tools and passions to make it happen. My mission personally has a lot to do with ascension, obviously, but that translates into being a bridge to anchor the energy of peace and anchor the energy of unity. Peace and unity, both within individuals, in the being, and in the collective. So this vision continues to manifest in many ways. When I help others empower themselves and move into their soul level potential, this anchors the energy of peace and unity. Peace as they accept and trust themselves on deeper levels, unity as they claim and embody more of who they really are and feel increasingly whole and complete. So when I heal within myself and embody more of myself, then in turn, change that into expression and into action, this anchors the energy of peace and unity. This is always the purpose for me, this energy of peace and unity. So once you've tuned into your why, once you've really allowed yourself to go into this vision of this why, what is my divine light mission? What is it that I feel so called to? What is my vision for the earth as I would choose it? Just allow yourself some time to sit with that. Once you've tuned into that and you can really feel the emotions of it and you can really begin to tap into that vision, then start to ask these questions to yourself. So again, depending on what's going on in the world at the time when you're listening to this, asking yourself, how can I show up as my soul level self during a global pandemic? What needs to heal within myself? What message do I need to express? What actions can I take to help support my vision? You can also ask yourself, how can I examine racism within myself and understand the role that I play? What needs to be healed, dismantled, or expressed within me? And if you're not sure where to start with this, I'm currently reading Me and White Supremacy by Layla F. Saad, and I totally recommend if you are white or white passing that you check out that book as well and work through the exercises in it. So ask yourself, what actions can I take to help support my vision? So again, you're bringing it all back into your vision. You're bringing it all back into your soul divine connection. You can also be asking, how can I support local business? How can I support businesses that hold a similar vision to me? How can I donate my time or my money or spend my money in areas that create the type of economy I want to be a part of? Your dollars are votes for the type of world you want to live in. Every purchase you make is a vote for that company. This is really beneficial for your money energy as well, right? When you are spending money in ways that empowers you, in ways that adds to your vision and adds to your divine light mission, whenever your outgoing money is making you that happy, it allows more money to come in. And then you allow this beautiful flow and this beautiful spiral of money for good. So it's like prosperity with a higher purpose. It's this beautiful, beautiful energy. So again, your dollars are votes for the world you want to live in. Now, I know that it's easier not to do the work, obviously. It's much easier to avoid it or to gloss over it without going into the depths. And this is your choice. When you start to do the work, or if you've been doing the work for a while, you're going to know what I'm talking about. You're going to likely want to give up. I have many times wanted to throw it all away and go live in a cave somewhere. So many different times. This is natural as you do deep inner work, but you're going to come out on the other side with much more clarity and conviction. Always, always moving deeper into your soul level self. Now, be sure that you have support. Be sure that you have the tools in place to help you move through your depths, but not be confused into thinking that you have to stay there. We visit, we bring healing, we process, we integrate, and then we come back to society to deepen our role and understand more of our puzzle piece here. This is a huge period of ascension and evolution for humanity, and 2020 is really a game changer year. When you tune into your vision and you're really big, this soul-driven why, it becomes less about forcing yourself to take action and more about being compelled and called to take action. You're working with this energy of divine strength. You're not relying only on your will, which can be easily freaked out. You are instead calling upon your whole being, this larger part of you. She's got this. She is a warrior of light, and she draws her strength from your vision and light mission. Already, we can see the glimmers of unity and peace. We can see that under all that suppressed human heaviness, there is hope, and there is this desire to do better, to move towards unity and peace. And only you can fulfill your puzzle piece of ascension. Only you can contribute in your unique, needed way. There's no more time for excuses. So use your toolbox and get to work. On a final note, so we're called to action. Yes, that's 100% true. Action is imperative. But because we're still moving through this this energy of this the patriarchy and this masculine energy, all of these programs that are subconsciously running for us, some of us may ignore intuitive nudges for resting, for meditation, for fun, and for joy. These energies are needed as much as the action for the change. There has to be a balance, this ebb and this flow. When you consider a child and when you consider them playing and creating and how adaptable they are and how they're how they can adapt and how they can change and how they can be so open-hearted and they can be so so willing to see things from a different perspective and to really dive into what the possibilities are, what the imagination is. We need imagination for this next phase of ascension, right? For all of these changes that are taking place, we need our imagination. We need the joy. We need the energy of fun. So don't ignore whenever you get nudges for that, right? It's not avoiding the work if you're not doing the work all the time. Be consistent with the work, but also allow your intuitive nudges to guide you into what you need. So maybe you're going to dive deep. You're going to dive into some self-reflection work. You're going to dive into a deep shamanic journey, asking yourself, where does racism lie within me? You're spending time doing that. You're getting down into, you know, the very, very roots. You're healing within yourself. And then you're understanding more. And then you're asking how you're taking action. And then maybe you're just like, okay, now it's time for me to play with my kids for a while. Now it's time for me to do some art, do something creative that is fun. And at first, our subconscious might be like, okay, but that's not useful. But that's not helping. It is, because you still need that energy flow. You can't just cut off a piece of yourself because you know that it's important to do the work. It's important to be the being that you need to be for this ascension. All right, I feel like I've got that rant out enough. So there has to be a balance, this ebb and this flow. Remember that as you are doing the work. Doing the work, caring for yourself deeply. So this ascension is sustainable for you. Sustainability in ascension is very important. If you just go in, you know, once a year and you do some really deep work and then you don't bring it up and express it, you don't take action on it, you're just doing little sprints of ascension. And you can go deeper. You can create this sustainable ascension process for yourself, but it involves listening to your intuitive nudges as well. All right. So thank you so, so much for joining me today. And you can get any details to anything I mentioned. The links will be in the show notes below. Thank you so much and have a wonderful day.